Hello everyone. So yesterday we studied about chapter number 12, that is electricity. In electricity we learned about resistance, that was Ohm's law. In Ohm's law we studied about the direct relation between the potential difference and electric current. Fine. And you know what is Ohm's law? That was V is equals to IR. In this Ohm's law we also studied about the factors on which the resistance depends. The factors on which resistance depends was known as first length, second was area, and third material. Fine. And so what do I told you? That here the resistance is directly proportional to L, resistance is inversely proportional to area, and therefore we can write that R is directly proportional to L upon A. R is directly proportional to L upon A. So to remove this proportionality sign from here, what we did, we write R is equals to rho L upon A. Here rho is resistivity. As I told you earlier, the resistivity is the resistivity of the material of the resistance. Can you get that? It is the values of the resistance what we find in the Ohm's law. So this is the value, as I told you, that 5 ampere will be the values of electric current. The same way resistivity is the values of resistance. Resistivity is the values of resistance. Fine. So here rho is the resistivity, also known as proportionality constant. One more thing, from here you can make this object of formula rho, then A gets over here, and so this becomes RA upon L. Rho is equals to RA upon L. Fine. And so this R is resistance, A is area, L is length, and rho is the resistivity. We also talked about the SI unit. The SI unit of resistivity is ohm meter. The SI unit of resistivity is ohm meter. Fine. So this you need to keep in mind. This is the resistivity, or we can also say the values of the resistance. Now I hope you all know about what is resistance. Resistance is the values, or say it resists the flow of electric current. Means it is creating a disturbance in the flow of electric current. Fine. So SI unit of rho is ohm meter. The SI unit of rho is ohm meter. Fine. I hope you are clear with these things. One more thing we did yesterday was series connection of resistors. Fine. Series connection of resistors. In the series connection of resistors, I told you that the circuit will look like this. Okay, and these were the resistors which are in series. That means there is no joint between the three resistors, then it is said to be a series connection resistors. Fine, this is the voltage V what we were applying, and the general formula what we did yesterday was something like this. V is equals to IR. For these three we wrote as V1 is equals to IR1. V2 is equals to IR2, and V3 is equals to IR3. Okay, so what we did in the next topic, that was V is equals to V1 plus V2 plus V3. Fine. Now we can substitute the values of IR, that is V. So we can write over here that IR is equals to IR1 plus IR2 plus IR3. Okay. Now we can remove the I common out from here, and so that was like R1 plus R2 plus R3. Now cancel this I, so we will get R is equals to R1 plus R2 plus R3. And this was our final answer for finding a series collection of resistors. So this is the formula for the series collection of resistors, where we can find simply by adding all the values of resistance and we can get the answers. We are going to solve many examples of this so that you will be clear with this topic. Okay, but today what we are going to start is the next topic after this, that is parallel connection of resistors. Fine. Parallel connection of resistors. In parallel connection of resistors, the figure will be something different. Let us see over here. Fine. So this is the figure for parallel connection of resistors. Here you can see these are the three resistors, that is R1, R2 and R3, and this is the voltage given over here. From here the electric current passes. As the electric current goes over here, it distributes in the three way, that is this, this and this. Again after passing through this resistors, it again comes over here and finishes over here. Fine. So here you can see, students, there is a joint between the three resistors, and the same joints are found in our household applications where we are using different types of electrical appliances. Okay, if we are going to switch, see, this will be the main meter of the electric board in our home. So if we will switch on the first switch, then only say this R1 is fan, then fan will get on. Say this is a tube light and we are going to switch on, this will be the light will be on, and say this R3 is PV, then there will be another switch passing through here, and if we will keep on, then PV will be on. Fine. So over here the electric current is always distributed. Okay, but over here you can see that voltage was getting distributed and electric current was same everywhere. Fine, electric current was same everywhere, and so this was something like I everywhere. But what happens here? If electric current reaches over here, it is I1. If it reaches over to here and here, then it will be I3. I hope you are clear with this experiment. This is the positive terminal, this is the negative terminal. This was also the positive terminal, this was the negative terminal. Fine. So this is the basic schematic diagram of parallel connection of resistors. You need to draw this in exam and it is quite important too. Now let us solve this by applying the Ohm's law. So what was our Ohm's law, students? It was something like V is equals to IR. Fine. Now I can write instead of this, I is equals to V upon R. Okay. So now I am having one more equation, that I is equals to V upon R. Similarly, for the three different resistors, I can also write the same thing. I1 is equals to V upon R1. I2 is equals to V upon R2. I3 is equals to V upon R3. I hope you are clear with this. For the first resistance, I wrote the formula I1 is equals to V upon R1. For the second resistance, I wrote the formula I2 is equals to V upon R2. And for the third resistance, I wrote the formula I3 is equals to V upon R3. Whereas this I is equals to V upon R is the sum of all the resistors. Okay. Now I can write like this here. I is equals to I1 plus I2 plus I3. Okay, now what we can do is, we can substitute the values of electric current over here. What is the values of electric current? V upon R. See, this is V upon R. What is I1? V upon R1, V upon R2, V upon R3. You can find out what is common over here, that is potential difference or say the voltage. Remove this potential difference common out. Inside you can write 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon R3. Okay, so here you can see that the both the sides potential difference are common. Cut this. So now we are only left with a formula. 1 upon R is equals to 1 upon R1, 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon R3. So students, this is the general formula for parallel connection of resistors. This is the general formula for parallel connection of resistors. Fine, you need to start from here. First of all, you need to draw the schematic diagram showing that the electric current is going on changing. Then comes the resistance and the potential difference, that is voltage. Then we need to write the Ohm's law, that is S common as V is equals to IR. And after writing this V is equals to IR, you need to write that I is equals to V upon R. After I is equals to V upon R, you need to state the, all the three formulas for the resistance. And so that will be I1 is equals to V upon R1, I2 is equals to V upon R2, and I3 is equals to V upon R3. Okay, so now next thing is what? If I is equals to I1 plus I2 plus I3, we can substitute the values of all the three equations as well as this capital I. The equation of the capital I was V upon R. So I wrote over here V upon R. So V upon R1, V upon R2, V upon R3 from here. You know that V is common out everywhere. So I removed the common V. And so I wrote 1 upon R is equals to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon R3. Fine. So this is the general formula for the parallel connection of resistors. This is the general formula for parallel connection of resistors. As well as this was the general formula for series connection of resistors. Okay. One thing you can see over here was what? That over here electric current is kept constant. Electric current is constant. Whereas over here in parallel connection you can see that potential difference is constant. Potential difference is constant. Okay? I know the board work is quite and tidy, but still, I hope you have understood these things. Okay? This was the factors on which the resistance depends. Fine? This was the series connection of resistance, and this was the parallel connection of resistance. I am going to solve one illustration over here, an example, so that you can be clear with this parallel connection of resistance. Fine? So, let us take an example, fine, and we are taking a parallel connection. See students, parallel connection can be drawn as well as this also. Okay, can you get this thing? This is a parallel connection. And this is the battery. Okay, name these things as R is equals to 2, 1 and name this as 2. State this R2 is equals to 4 and R3 is equals to 8. Fine, I have named the three resistances as 2, 4 and 8. I am taking randomly, I don't know what answer we will get. But R1 is 2 ohm and don't try to draw the SI unit over here, that is ohm. So R1 is 2 ohm, R2 is 4 ohm and R3 is 8 ohm. Fine, and I am passing a potential difference, that is a battery connected over here and electric current is passing like this and then coming again at the negative terminal. So students, you can see that if the electric current from here is passing through three more ways rather than one, then it is said to be a parallel connection. Here you can see that there are three ways for one electric current. This arrow is stated as electric current. Okay. So you can find out the difference between the by seeing the figure, that what is the parallel connection or what is the series connection of resistance. I repeat, if the electric current is being distributed in more than one or two ways, then it is said to be parallel connection. And if the electric current is not changing or is not being distributed its way, then it will be a series connection of resistance. Fine. So students, you can see over here that this is the parallel connection of resistance, and we need to solve this. In examinations, they will be telling us that find the equivalent resistance of the given circuit. Okay, so question will be like this. They will be giving us a figure and they will be writing that find the equivalent resistance of the given circuit. Then you need to draw the figure first of all, and then what we will do, as you can see that this is a resistance connected in parallel connection, then what we will do, then we will write the general formula. First of all, write here R1 is equal to 2 ohm, R2 is equal to 4 ohm and R3 is equal to 8 ohm. Okay. Now the next step will be write the general formula. So general formula will be 1 upon R is equal to 1 upon R1, 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon R3. What we did just now over here was the derivation. Okay, this was the proof that how we were getting R1 upon R is equal to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon R3. This is the final formula. Now we only need to deal with this formula and not the whole thing what we need to write. The box what I have drawn over here, find that only we need to solve. Now students, we are having three values, that is 2, 4 and 8. We can submit those values over here, and so this becomes 1 upon 2, 1 upon 4, 1 upon 8. Okay. So we need to take the LCM over here. See students, you can also take the two things together combined and take the LCM or do the cross multiplication, whatever you like. And if I have taken the values like 2, 4 and 8, that means they are the multiples of what? Of course, 2, 4 and 8 are the multiples of 2. Then I can also take the LCM combined. I am just now taking the LCM combined. So the first rule of LCM is what? That the base, that the denominator should be same. Fine. The denominator should be same. So what I am taking is, say 8 is the greatest number and that is the LCM. Then I can multiply any number with 8, that becomes 8. So that is 1. I am also writing 1 over here. Say this number 4, I need to multiply it by 2, then I also need to multiply the numerator with 2. So 1 into 2, but 4 into 2 is 8. Here 8 into 1 is 8. Now what I need to do? I will multiply this number with 4 and this number also with 4. Okay. So 1 upon R is equal to 1 into 4 plus 1 into 2 plus 1 into 1. Now what happens over here? See students. 4 ones are 4 plus 2 plus 1. Okay. And the base is, you can see all same, 4 2s are 8, 4 2s are 8, 8 1s are 8. So this will be 8. So now you can write over here, 1 upon r is equals to 7 upon 8. 1 upon r is equals to 7 upon 8. But what we need resistance over here. We need resistance over here. Okay. And so, what we will do? Interchange this. And so this becomes 8 upon 7 ohm. So this is the equivalent resistance of the given circuit. This is the equivalent resistance of the given circuit. I hope you are clear with this, students. Okay. Fine. If you are having doubt, you can inform me. But we are going to solve many circuits on the very next lecture. Or after that, first of all, we will solve all the examples of the textbook and the illustrations which are given in the textbook, and then we will do some extra sums on this, because this chapter is quite important in future also. Okay. So r is equals to 8 upon 7. See, there can be a change in this equation. Suppose, say, they have given us something like the electric current flowing over here is 49 ohm. Say, electric current passing over here is 49 ampere. Sorry. Okay. And they will be asking that now find the voltage given in the circuit. So, we need to again apply the Ohm's law, but that will be easy. First of all, you need to find this resistance. Once you are clear with this resistance, what we need to do? 1 upon r is equal to 7 upon 8. Now, once you are getting 1 upon r is equal to 7 upon 8, or r is equal to 8 upon 7, and electric current they have given, that is 49 ampere. What we need to do? V is equal to IR. Substituting the values of electric current, what was electric current? Say 49 multiplied by R. What was R? 8 upon 7. You can cut this and this with, of course, 7. And 8 sevens are what? 56 voltage. This is your final voltage of the equation. Fine, students. I hope you are clear with this. Okay, they can also ask you the electric current, and you need to find by the formula I is equals to V upon R. If they are asking us the voltage, I told you just now, then V is equals to I. And if they are asking us the electric current, then you need to write I is equals to V upon R. I is equals to V upon R. Fine? I hope you are clear with this. But the thing is, they are not asking the individual questions like this. Say this is only parallel connection, or yesterday the sum I solved was the only series connection. He will be asking us the question in which there is a combination of series connection as well as the parallel connection. Then we need to solve it both. I am doing with one example just now. Okay. Say, we are taking a figure and they will be asking you the same questions what I told you. Find equivalent resistance. Okay, they will be asking you find the equivalent resistance. So students, you can see over here that when the electric current is passing from the battery, first of all it goes over here, and this is what we known as parallel connection. But after passing through this three, that is parallel connection, it passes from here to here. Then you can see that these both are in series connection. Fine, these both are in the series connection. As well as of what we will find over here, what we did over here, this will be also a single resistance, and that will be also in the form of series connection. Fine, so it is quite different to solve. Let us try that. But first of all, we will do the first step, that is, we need to solve this parallel connection, because this is the first one, R1, R2, and R3. Then write over here 1 upon R, say I am telling 1 upon R prime is equals to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon R3. Okay, now what happens? 1 upon R prime is equals to, what was the values of R1? 1 upon 1, 1 upon 2, 1 upon 3. Keep this 1 aside and cross multiply this. 3 1s are 3 plus 2 1s are 2 upon 6. Okay, I hope you are clear with this. Then what happens? 3 plus 2 is 5, right? 1 plus 5 upon 6. Okay, 1 plus 5 upon 6. Now 6 1s are 6 plus 5, 11. 11 upon 6. So over here I will be having the answer 1 upon R prime is equals to 11 upon 6. I hope you are clear with this. Fine students, 1 upon R prime is equals to 1 plus 6, 1s are 6 plus 5. So that is 11 upon 6. But I will go R prime, so that will be 6 upon 11. What the next thing we need to do is, see, this R prime is the combination of this whole circuit. So instead of that, now I can draw this. Okay, name this as R prime. That was something like 6 upon 11 ohm. This was a regular R4, that was 2 ohm, and R5 was also 2 ohm. So students, now you can see over here that I have solved the parallel connection and brought it into the simple form, and this simple form is what? Series connection. Because this is positive charge, this is negative. Electric current flows from here to here. What happens? It will be a series connection. It will be series connection. So what we need to do? We need to solve the regular thing. Name this as capital R. First was what? R prime, then it was R4 plus R5. So this becomes R is equals to R prime is what? 6 upon 11, 2 plus 2. This 2 plus 2, take LCM everywhere. 6 plus 11 2s are 22 plus 11 2s are 22 upon 11. So R is equal to 22 plus 22, 44 plus 6, that will be 50 upon 11. So this will be your final answer. This will be your final answer. And this equation is also known as combination of series and parallel circuits. The combinations of series and parallel circuits. I hope you are clear with this. If you are not clear, please ask me in the doubt section, and I will solve the more questions like this. I hope you are clear today with the parallel connection of resistance. That was the main topic over there today. Okay. And if you have any doubts or any queries, please let me know. Okay. Today your homework will be the series connection of resistance and parallel connection of resistance you need to write. Okay. Thank you.